Alright, first up, let's talk about the issue at hand. When my machine is homing, my X-axis homing switch or inductive sensor, you know, the little black box that tells the thing stop, is not working. It does not tell that X-axis, hey, you're here at the end, quit moving. It allows it to keep going and going and going until it hits the stops and then starts chewing up the belt. I want to run through the process once just so you can see exactly what this issue is, because this is the specific issue I want to troubleshoot in today's video. I have another video talking about the fix for your Y axes if they want to home towards the front of your machine, in other words, backwards. There's also a video link on the settings and changes that I did for getting my bit setter to work on the Shapeoko Pro. So if you're having any of those issues, be sure and check out that video link down below, as well as others that may come up over time between now and you viewing this video. You never know what's going to come up. With that being said, let me go ahead and show you what issue I have going on, and let's begin to try and troubleshoot and fix this on our own. The first thing I want to do is unhook the power cord from the back of my X motor, and that's because I'm going to take this ZX assembly and slide it over to begin the troubleshooting process. In case you don't know, stepper motors are motors, meaning that electricity makes them run, or if they run, they make electricity. I don't want to backfeed anything over here by moving this thing around manually. That's why I'm going to disconnect the X-axis motor at the back. With the motor disconnected, I can now move this assembly over with no concerns about generating electricity and frying my board. Now that it moved out of the way, I will reconnect the motor. Alright, we're going to go ahead and go through the homing process, and I will illustrate the issue for you here. This carriage is going to move over, the sensor, for whatever reason, is not going to do its job, and it's going to start making a grinding sound. At that point, I'm cutting the power and killing the machine. I don't want to continue to grind my belts. Did you hear the buzz though? It's not perfect. I don't think it's bumping back off of the axis. You hear it? It's like dancing. That was good. It only took one try to rehome this thing to get the issue to happen. The issue was it went to the X-axis, hit pretty hard, ground a little bit, stopped, and then when the Y-axis got all the way to the back, it started doing a doom, 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 like some techno music going on. But that X-axis was trying to find that homing switch. It couldn't find it. Popped up an error on carbide motion. Cannot find homing switch. What's up? So, now let's go down the road of figuring out why it's doing that, and if we can fix it. Talking last night with a couple of the people that are on the Facebook Shapeoko group, link to that down below by the way, if you're not a member, you're going to want to check it out because it is an invaluable resource for information, sharing ideas, projects, files, whatever, and just kind of collectively meeting with like-minded people with the same kind of machines. Anyway, one of the guys in the Facebook group last night was talking about how you can test your homing switches to make sure they're actually doing their job. He said that during the homing cycle, if you take a metallic object, put it right in front of that switch, it should light up and it should stop moving that axis because it should think that it's at its home point at that part. Another way you can test it is if you have the settings window open while the machine is on, not like running, but just powered on and waiting. You put a metal object near it and you'll see a little pop-up down at the very bottom of the settings window that shows you what axis or sensor is saying, hey, there's something there, guys. So let's run through the test with metallic object in front of my X-axis sensor during the homing cycle to see if it stops moving that XZ assembly. And that will at least tell me that the sensor and the board are doing what they should do. Here we go. So Z, X. Yep, it stopped X. So my sensor seems okay. Alright, so that worked. As soon as this knife got close to the homing sensor, it lit up, it stopped moving the assembly, and pretty much said, "Whoa, Nelly." At that point, because I didn't move the knife away, Carbide Motion said, "Whoa, something's wrong," and it gave me the error of homing failed, pull off didn't clear. What that means is, it's supposed to have the machine cranking along, senses it, tells the board, "Whoa, stop," and then it backs up a little. Kind of gives it some space, you know, personal space. Well, I didn't do that with the knife. So what I'm going to do next is repeat the same exact test, but as soon as the carriage stops, I'll bump the knife away and see if I make Carbide Motion happy at that point. Fingers crossed. Ah ha ha! We have ourselves a successful homing cycle. That tells us the switch works, the board works, the software is good, the connection's good, the stars must be aligned, but our issue lies in the physical realm. Oh yeah, getting a little geeky here, sorry. Okay, so what that tells me is the switch is not exactly aligned properly. When I look at the sensor from the side, it doesn't exactly line up dead on with that front faceplate of the assembly. I'm gonna bring it forward, towards me, off the rail a little bit, to make it more in line or coplanar with that assembly plate. I think between these two, we might just have this issue fixed, but we won't know until we do some science experiments. Where's my chewing gum? Looks like those screws are pretty long enough, so that's good. All right, now I'm gonna take what every CNC operator should have, some blue painter's tape, and fish it in behind this sensor to space it off the rail a little bit here. At the same time, I'm gonna have to clip that zip tie off because it's keeping me from moving the sensor. Alright, with the zip tie released, I can now move the sensor forward a little bit. Not a tight fit with those holes. And I'll go ahead and back it out a little bit more. I don't want to go too far. I still want to make sure these bolts have enough thread to bite in. Alright, I have my masking tape spacer in place. I'm going to move this all the way to the left again and tighten these bolts back down. Alright. Let's give this thing a shot, see if it does any better now. This is looking promising. This is looking really promising. I'm going to continue with the homing cycle, which for Shapeoko Pro owners with your bit setter enabled is run it through the bit setter, find out where that bit is. I'm going to click to load the tool and let it go through that cycle to give myself a complete start to finish successful homing sequence before I say, give me a high five. This is looking good, guys. We got ourselves completely successfully homed. However, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna run through this thing 5 times. I want 5 successful machine homing cycles or sequences before I really say, you know what? That was the fix. Guys, that's it, that's the fix. Spacing that sensor off that gantry brought it in line enough with the XZ assembly to sense the metal and do what it does. Nice. I don't have a bad switch. I don't have a bad board. Don't have a bad USB cable. It's not static electricity. And it's not just the fact that I broke a mirror the other day and have 7 years bad luck. All right. Now that I know this is the fix, I want to come up with something that is better than just some folded double dough over blue painter's tape. Because, I mean, come on. This is a nice looking machine. She deserves something better than blue tape. And I deserve to learn how to talk. There you go, guys. That was my permanent fix. I found some small little stainless steel nuts that I had in my junk hardware drawer. They just happened to slide over the M whatever's bolts. I don't even want to act like I know what the size they are. They're little. They slid over the end of the bolts and act as a little tiny spacer between the gantry rail and the sensor itself. Looks pretty good. Everything locked down tight, and I don't think there's any grounding questions, but the fact that the nuts are metal, it's all copacetic. Everybody's happy. So there's a quick fix. Now you know. Now you can get out into your shop. You can fix your X-axis homing issue on your Shapeoko Pro, and you can start throwing some chips with those feeds and speeds. Appreciate you guys watching as always. If you're not a subscriber, hit that subscribe button. This machine's new to me. It's new to a lot of people right now in December 2020. And therefore, as I run into things, I'll be sure and share with you guys what I learned. Tips, tricks, hacks, fix, whatever else. And yes, for you guys not wanting to buy a CNC, you're just hanging out with Samcraft and seeing, well, what they're doing now, there will be projects. I promise, there are projects. Either way, I'll see you guys next time in the workshop.